Today, we are going to walk you through the process of installing the complementary tooling used to collect the on-premises inventory and utilization for your business case to AWS with Migration Evaluator. Once your request for a business case has been processed, you will receive an email invitation. Simply create an account on the Migration Evaluator Management Console, and you will have access to the guides, software, and everything else needed to deploy the software. Please take the time to review the pre-install checklist found in the installation guide for the appropriate server specifications, English version of Windows Server, Windows Administrator rights, network connectivity, and required permissions. Having the required setting upfront will simplify the deployment. Step 1 will be to install, as a local administrator, the Bootstrapper, which automatically installs any missing third-party software packages. This includes the .NET runtime and local MariaDB instance. If a drive other than C was allocated to meet the storage requirements, please click Options and select the correct drive. Step 2 is to install, as a local administrator, the collector software. To ensure your inventory is only accessible to your assessment, each collector has a unique certificate provided by AWS and is downloaded from the Migration Evaluator Management Console. You will be prompted to select the certificate file during the installation. Next, you will be prompted to run the collector either under a local system account or the service account created prior to installation. Please review the system requirements and installation guide for more details on service accounts. Please note that the account selected cannot be changed after install. Next, select HTTPS to require encryption with the IIS application, and select Yes to automatically start the collection service once the install sequence finishes. The final step of installing the software is to create a local account to manage the collector. This will not be the account you created to download the software. Simply launch a browser and enter your desired credentials. If you ever forget your password, a unique recovery key is saved to the collector's file system and can be used to create a new account. Step 3 is to configure collection from VMware. If you do not have VMware infrastructure to monitor, please skip to the next section of this video. From the collector software, select Add Data Provider, then VMware vSphere. You will be prompted to enter a descriptive label, the address of the vSphere appliance, and read-only credentials. After pressing Save, you will see the name of the vCenter added in the list of data providers. Select it and check the status to ensure the vCenter says online. As it is common for vSphere instances to be deployed with a self-signed certificate, you may need to either disable SSL certificate validation or fix the certificate installed on the vCenter being monitored. After you make the configuration change, you may force the software to try connecting again by selecting Advanced Status and Force Data Collection. Repeat this process for each vSphere application to be included in the assessment. Step 4 is to configure read-only WMI or SNMP credentials to be used by the collector. Please skip to the next section of this video if your environment is VMware only and you would like to right-size based on hypervisor utilization only. From the collector software, navigate to Global Settings and select the OS Credentials tab. Each credential added may be used later for monitoring virtual machines directly, bare metal, or Hyper-V host system infrastructure. You can enter as many as are needed, and the software will automatically detect the correct one to use for each server. Step 5 is to configure collection from bare metal servers. If you do not have bare metal infrastructure to monitor, please skip to the next section of this video. To start, you will need to create a CSV file containing the list of servers to be monitored. Please review the system requirements and installation guide for details. Next, from the collector software, select Add Data Provider, then Migration Evaluator CSV. Upload the CSV file, then save. The system will now begin to asynchronously add the servers, which may take up to 10 minutes to complete. Repeat this process for each list of bare metal servers to be included in the assessment. To verify network connectivity and credentials provided earlier, select the Bare Metals view from Device Settings. Navigate to a server you would like to test and select Test Collection. If a server reports back as unhealthy, consult the System Requirements and Installation Guide for troubleshooting ideas. Step 6 is to configure collection from Hyper-V hosts. If you do not have Hyper-V infrastructure to monitor, please skip to the next section of this video. From the collector software, please add data provider, then Microsoft Hyper-V. If you have an Active Directory server, select Active Directory Scan, provide a descriptive label, the address of the Active Directory server, and read-only credentials. Alternatively, if an Active Directory server is not available, you may review the system requirements and installation guide to create a CSV file containing the list of hosts to be monitored. Provide a descriptive label and upload the CSV. The system will now begin to asynchronously add the servers. This initial cycle can take up to 10 minutes to complete. You can verify that the Hyper-V hosts and their virtual machines are discovered by selecting Device Settings from the navigation bar and selecting the Hyper-V view. Step 7 is to enable automatic SQL addition detection. If you do not have SQL Server instances to discover, please skip to the next section of this video. Start by adding one or more TSQL credentials. Select Global Settings from the navigation bar and the OS Credentials tab. Select New, then TSQL from the Protocol dropdown. Please note, domain accounts are not supported at this time. Once the credentials are added, select the OS Collection tab. For each data type configured, VMware, Ad Hoc, or Hyper-V, select Scan All at the top to initiate an SQL addition scan. Selecting Scan All is only needed to accelerate discovery during the installation process. Step 8 is to optionally configure resource utilization monitoring directly from the virtual machines discovered from the VMware or Hyper-V infrastructure. Enabling this allows the business case to factor in utilization from the server's point of view, which may allow for additional right-sizing. Start by selecting Global Settings from the navigation bar and the OS Collection tab. For each data type configured, VMware or Hyper-V, configure WMI and/or SNMP, then save. Note, this collection leverages the operating system's credentials configured in Step 4. You may add additional credentials at any time. Step 9 is an optional setting to enable synchronization with AWS. This allows the Migration Evaluator service team to provide alerts if collection is not in scope with expectation. The Amazon S3 synchronization settings are based on your collector details listed in the Migration Evaluator Management Console. Once configured, please select Initiate Backup Now to verify both the backup and synchronization is working. Our last step will be annotating the discovered inventory with business data and provisioning. After a few days of collection, navigate to Global Settings in the navigation bar and select the Backup tab, and click the Download Inventory and Utilization Export button at the bottom. On the virtual and physical asset sheets, verify the inventory contains everything expected to be in scope. For servers without detected physical provisioning, fill in as much as possible with values acceptable for modeling. For database servers, verify and populate the database type column where needed. On the asset ownership sheet, fill in as much as possible, including the server's logical environment, by providing production versus development tags. With these tags, extra projected savings may be able to be modeled. Once your annotations are completed, upload the updated Excel workbook for your engagement in the Migration Evaluator Management Console at console.tsologic.com/discover/self-reported-files. thank you for taking the time to watch our installation and configuration of the Migration Evaluator Collector software. We hope you found it helpful to walk through the process of an installation and configuration to ensure you are ready to begin your Migration Evaluator engagement.